One in five has chronic pain globally. One in three will be getting cancer globally. This is not okay. We're not moving in the right direction.
I'm from Saskatchewan, Canada, and the reason I'm here is because of a lot of the keynote speakers are guys that I follow and heard the work of, and I just wanted to hear the work straight from their mouth. And it's been incredible and a phenomenal conference so far.
There's a kind of change, there's something in the wind that is sort of blowing up, and that comes from fascia.
We also have to think that Rome wasn't built in one day.
Yeah, I come all the way in Bali, so I'm very happy. So there is like researchers, anatomists, surgeons, and also like movement therapists like me that, yeah, really get it, and we can share like insights and knowledge about it.
I just thought I'd like to meet people, primarily. Like I can see through the internet, but it's a one way. So I'd like to discuss and interact with people.
The concept, what you are doing, and what we are doing, a slightly different approach, but it combined together might be a very good synergy.
This is really cool to see the science behind this, and this is top-notch science. This is really the newest one. So I'm very happy to be here.
Thanks to interstitium, because I was trained as a surgeon on cataract.
Do you think it's important that you gather people from different places of the world and meet each other?
Of course, of course.
What can it give?
Well, if we have to share. We have to share, we have to exchange.
I think this this conference was fantastic, or still is, because it included so many interesting presentations. Mm. So I'm glad to have been invited to be one of them.
When we published our first interstitium paper, suddenly I was communicating with Fascia World, and they were going, that's what we were talking about. Chinese medicine people, that's what we were talking about. We all use different metaphors, different languages, different approaches, but it seems to be, as the fascia and interstitium is a communication network through the body, the anatomy seems to be a communication network that can span cultures of health and healing. So, can it be a cultural and linguistic bridge to move us towards a real global medicine rather than Western medicine or shamanic medicine or energy healing? Why are these separate things? There's a single body. Shouldn't we have a single culture of healing?
The people I've met, the people I've learned from, they show that if we just change our perspective, we can probably solve these things. Not all of them. Not all of these billions of people are suffering, but a lot of them. We can do a lot. If we just have the resources, the network, the people, the belief that we can do something, and this event was about that.